blessed that to have a mother like I had. I will love her with an everlasting love. I often called Kitty my sainted mother. I got that from Arnold, actually. And those of you who knew her well know that she was truly a living saint. Not a traditional saint, but one who knew the call of Jesus. For you see, Jesus himself was just like Kitty. Radical. A radical love. They were and are the example of hospitality, of goodness, of joy, compassion, and devotion. There was a time when Jesus threw the tables in front of the temple over because of injustice as well as frustration and being able to recognize people for who they really are. There was a time, I remember, Kitty throwing over the dining room table, macaroni everywhere. Kitty knew people for who they really are. And many times you could see right through their very souls and spirits, just like Jesus. She knew that they could do better, and she never stopped loving, feeding, or caring for them. One of the greatest examples was the care and love she gave to her husband, my father, for many years of his illness. She never wavered in her loving care. I would say during my dad's eulogy that Kitty and Joe would forever be the most elegant couple on the dance floor. But Kitty was a far better dancer in life itself. From the cheerleading field that Aunt Jenny talked about at her bedside, to the endless and fearless adventures with her family and friends that Andy reminded me of. To her amazing courage and love of life that was there for so many years. Her leadership at the New Jersey Meadowlands. I could still see my mother walking onto that field at Giant Stadium. She was a superstar. She was the athlete who showed the world what teamwork and perseverance was and is. Kitty's call to family, faith, and devotion did not end with her husband, her work, her love, drawing, gardening, feeding the hungry. It grew and expanded to her children, to me, to Michael, to Nancy. And like my dad, the dedication Kitty had for our beautiful and amazing sister Nancy is unparalleled to any I have seen in all my years. Kitty, an early fighter at ADA, the rights of all children knew no bounds. Her quest for social justice and doing the right thing never ended. Her unwavering call to motherhood stood by Michael and me during our darkest hours. She never judged, never stopped loving, and it has taught me more than I could have ever imagined. Some of you have been telling me I am becoming a better priest. Lord knows I have made so many mistakes in life, and this call to God is my redemption. But it is not all those years in school or seminary that is teaching me what faith is. It is this time I spent first at my mother's dining room table. But it is also the time I spent around Kitty's hospital bed, surrounded by so many of you, showing me God and being the living example of what we're all supposed to do for faith. That is what family, love, and God is all about. And I thank you all for that. After my dad died, Daryl and I wanted to help Mom and our family. I wanted to build a house next to hers and hope that we could all live together as a family. Sadly, that never happened. It would have been a beautiful dream. But joyfully, Daryl and I were able to move right into that same house. It's been nearly 18 years since I came back to live with my mom in Florida. And it has been the most wonderful experience of my life. Being able to come down for morning coffee, endless dinner leftovers from one of the greatest cooks I have ever known, was just the icing on the cake of the past 2 decades. Our next door extended family, a Bronco and Leah. Our family cruises, holidays, Florida with our grandchildren. Thanksgiving in Long Island. Vacations to Las Vegas. And lastly, the trip that we took to Mexico and Arizona. Kitty wanted to go to Lourdes, and I told her about the American Mission Trail, the American Holy Land. And we spent 7 days visiting the most beautiful churches I have ever seen. We ended that trip, of course, in a casino with our cousin Kitty. Which is just so fitting for Kitty itself. But thank you, God. Thank you, Kitty, for those adventures, those memories, that love. But what happens now? The past few months and days have been a blur. And I could not have done any of this without Dow, Diane, Jennifer, without Dr. Steve, Jimmy and Danny. Barbara and Rocky, on one of their last trips, and they were men, were sitting around on the bedside. And then I knew I had to get Kitty messages of hope. So I began asking people, what's your greatest memory? Kitty, as Kitty was listening, Rocky was crying. His greatest memory was, I have to quote him. She told me how to curse and smoke, and I learned it really well. But then he added how she was there for him during so many tough times. That night continued with Anthony, bringing us food, and his beautiful mother, Jenny. Jenny's memory, as she rolled next to Kitty and told Kitty how much she loved her, and Kitty responded back. In room 132. Kitty, he sang play that number today. Yeah. Jenny said, my favorite memory is you in that cheerleading uniform. The first Fairview kid to become a Cliffside Park High School cheerleader. I prayed and blessed Kitty that night, that last full night. I said to her, we played that song that you will hear next to her. The nurse brought me in a lounge chair to comfort me. I wrote this tribute that night, and then I read it to her. Then we ended as my dad was dying out with Dean Martin, a favorite singer. The song that came on the track was Dance With Me. I said, what a song. It was by far the most holy and sacred night, and a gift of love and grace that I have ever had. Today we say goodbye to a body, just a body, one that is clearly ingrained in over the past years. Mom avoided doctors like the plague, and maybe she was right. She sadly got worse and worse each day at the hospital. But today we celebrate Kitty in paradise. Even more beautiful than her beloved long-ago Kitty, she is with God. She is with her parents, Vito and Mary, as well as Nick and Ida. Her brothers, Arnold, Steve, and Sam. And so many friends she loved. But I hope right now, she is doing one of those public dances with my dad. Kitty, you blessed us. Oh, with your spirit, your fearless courage, your amazing sense of humor, Kitty, you told it like it was, and you were right. You were right about those who were good, kind, real, caring. I saw it at your bedside. It was a tribute to one of the most powerful and beautiful people until we meet again. Sweet mother, I will close with one of your famous lines. See you on the farm, Miss Kitty. Thank you for being you. I will love you with an everlasting love, because I'm forgettable. That is what you want. Dara will now be playing the auditory song that Nancy requested. I messed up on that one. And that song.